So, today we start learning about bones of upper limb. Bones of upper limb. Consists of bones of girdle and bones of free upper limb. Bones of girdle. Ossa trunci ossa cinguli, membri superioris. And free ossa membri inferioris liberti. Cinguli consists of two bones, clavicle and scapula. What about clavicle? Clavicle is S-shape and has body, corpus clavicula. Clavicle in Latin the same name, clavicula. Corpus clavicula and two ends. And in Latin extremitas. So this looks to the sternum. Extremitas sternalis. This looks to the process on the scapula. This process on the scapula named acromion. So, extremitas acromialis. Only name clavicle, corpus clavicula, extremitas sternalis, extremitas acromialis. And on inferior surface we have tubercle, conoid tubercle, tuberculum conoidum, and line, linea trapezoidea, trapezoid line. That's all. Next, scapula. This is left because this angle is lateral. So, look behind me like this. Okay. Scapula. This is flat bone. Has three ends. Angle. And three borders. So, angulus inferior, angulus lateralis, angulus superior, and three borders, margo superior, margo medialis, margo lateralis. This is inner surface, looks to the rib. So, this is rib surface, facies costalis. On the costal surface, we have fossa, pit. This subscapular fossa. Fossa subscapularis. Behind. We have spine on scapula. Spina scapula. Spina scapula divided on superior fossa and inferior. Fossa supra spinata. Fossa infra spinata. On the upper border, we have notch, incisura scapuli. Spina scapula then goes to the process. This is acromion, the same name in Latin and English. Acromion connects with the clavicle. And lateral angle. On the lateral angle, we have this articular surface. For connect with the humerus. It has special name, cavitas glenoidalis. Above and below we have two tubercles. Above, tuberculum supraglenoidale. Below, tuberculum infraglenoidale. Around this surface we have a neck, collum scapulae. Above surface we have one more process. This is coracoid process. Processus coracoideus for muscles. Next, humerus. So, humerus attached to the scapula. What about humerus? So, this is left humerus. This is head of humerus, medial surface for the scapula. And behind humerus we have big pid, big pid. So this is behind, this is medial, this is left bone. Humerus is a long tubular bone. It has body, diaphysis, corpus humeri. Between ends, we have one more part, metaphysis, parts for growing. So, body and two ends. This is lower end, extremitas inferior, upper end, extremitas superior, extremitas superior. On superior extremitas, we have parts with for connection to another bones, articular. If something connect to another bones, this is epiphysis. If something connect with muscles, with ligaments, this is apophysis. So, what is proximal, close to the body? Epiphysis. So, this is head, head of humerus, caput humeri. Around caput humeri, we have neck. This is anatomical neck, colum anatomicum. On the this level, we have surgical neck, colum chirurgicum. This place is most breaking place. What is apophysis for ligaments and muscle? On the superior end, we have two tubercle, tuberculum minus, tuberculum minus. From tubercles, we have two crests. Crista tuberculi minoris, crista tuberculi majoris, crista tuberculi minoris. And between them, we have groove between two tubercles, sulcus intertubercularis. What about body? Upper part and lower part. Upper part is cylindrical. Lower part is trihedral. In the middle part, between them, we have one more tuberositas. Tuberositas for deltoid muscle. Tuberositas deltoidea. Behind, we have groove for radial nerve. Sulcus nervi radialis. Trihedral part of body. We have anterior border. Margo anterior, medial border, margo medialis, and margo lateralis, and three surfaces. Facies posterior, facies medialis, facies lateralis. So, now is distal end. For connection to another bones, this is epiphysis. What connects to another bone? This is condyle, condylus. In condylus, we have this part is trochanter. Трохля. Трохля хумери. And this part is трохля хумери. And this part is little head, capitulum. Capitulum хуми. So, condyle on the humerus consists of трохли, трохля хумери, and little head, capitulum хумери. What is about apophysis? Apophysis for ligaments and muscle. This is condyle, and above is epicondyle. Epicondylus medialis, epicondylus lateralis. Behind medial, we have one more groove. This groove for ulnar nerve. Sulcus nervi ulnaris. Also, we have three pits on the humerus. One pit above capitulum. This is radial pit. Fossa radialis. This pit for coronoid process. Fossa coronoida. And this is for ulnar process. Name olecranon. Fossa olecrani. Next bones. So, this is olecranon. And this notch incisura for trochli, incisura trochlearis. Attached to this bone like this, and olecranon goes to this fossa. This process is coronoid process, goes to coronoid fossa, fossa coronoidea. And this is radius, radius around capitulum, around little head. Next bone, In English, ulna. In Latin, ulna. Again, long tubular bone. Consists of body, corpus ulna, diaphysis. Between them, metaphysis. And this is end, superior end, extremitas superior, inferior end, extremitas inferior. On the superior end, we have parts for joint to another bones, epiphysis. So this is proximal epiphysis. This notch between two processes. This notch for trochlea, incisura trochlearis. This process, olecranon, ulnar process. And this process is coronoid process, processus coronoideus. On the coronoid process here, we have one more notch. This notch for radius, incisura radialis. Below, we have tuberositas of ulna, tuberositas ulna, and line for musculus supinator, linea musculus supinator. Body is trihedral, and this border looks to another bone, between two bones. So, we have margo interossus, margo anterior, margo posterior, facies anterior, facies posterior, and facies medialis. Lower end is head, caput ulna, has circular articular surface, because circular, its name is circumferentia ulnaris. And little process looks like style, styloid process, processus styloideus. Radius, in Latin radius, body, metaphysis, and two ends. Superior end has epiphysis, epiphysis for another bones. Epiphysis has, this is articular surface with capitulum. This articular surface to connect to ulna. This is round, circular articular surface, circumferentia radialis, for connect with incisura ulnaris. Okay. Below we have end. All this part named head, caput radii. Below head we have tuberositas, tuberositas radii. Then body, the same like ulna, it has one border between two bones. Again, margo interossus. And the same, margo anterior, margo posterior. Again the same, facies anterior, facies posterior, like ulna. But this surface looks to another side. On the ulna was facies medialis, on the radius facies lateralis. Lower end. Lower end has articular surface for connect to another bones. And what another bones? This is carpus. So this is facies articularis carpalis. And this is notch. Notch for ulna. Incisura ulnaris. Two bones connect with incisura, incisura, and round circumferentia, and one more circumferentia. Circumferentia to incisura. Okay. And two border looks to each other, interossean border. One more. For ligaments and muscles we have one more process, styloid process, processus styloideus. This one is lateral, because together we have processus styloideus medialis and processus styloideus lateralis. Next part. Here, head, hand. So this is left hand. And we have carpus, metacarpus, and digital phalanx.
Subcarpus.
Carpus, we have 8 bones in 2 rows. One is proximal, one is distal. You should know only names of these bones. So, os scaphoideum, os triquetrum, os lunatum, os lunatum, os triquetrum, os pisiforme. You can touch os pisiforme here. Yes. Next, os trapezium, os trapezoidum, os capitatum and os hamatum. Its name because it looks like, for example, os lunatum has this surface, looks like moon, os lunatum. For example, os hamatum has hook, os hamatum. Os capitatum has little head for lunatum. Little head, capitulum, capitatum. What next? Next is metacarpus. Metacarpus is 5 bones. There are here, metacarpus. And then we have phalanges. All other bones you should know only. It has base, basis. It has body, corpus, and head. Only one difference. All fingers has 3 phalanges. Proximal, medial, and distal. Only toe. Only big finger has proximal and distal. Only one finger has only 2 phalanges. Okay?
Yes, sir.
One.